Hello Windows Universe, in this video we're going to look at some things that you can try if your audio services are not responding in Windows 10. For a more in-depth look at the problem, we will link an article in the description down below that will go more into depth. Start by running the SFC and DISM. Open a command prompt as an administrator. Type in SFC space slash scan now, all one word, and hit enter. This might take a few minutes. When that is finished, type in DISM space slash online space slash clean up one word hyphen image space slash restore health and type enter. Depending on the amount of corruption, this could take 15 minutes or more. When it is finished, type exit, restart your system, and see if the problem has corrected itself. Restart your audio services. Open the run box. Type in services.msc. Okay. Scroll down to Windows Audio Service. Double click to open properties. Set the startup to automatic if it is not already, and click the start button. While you have services open, check the following and make sure they are running. If not, right click on them and start them. Also, make sure they are set to automatic. RPC Endpoint Mapper. Remote Procedure Call. DCOM Server Process Launcher. Close the services, restart your computer, and see if the problem is corrected. Install default sound drivers. To do this, press the Windows key and R. Type in Control System. OK. Open the Advanced System Settings. Open the Hardware tab and click on Device Installation Settings. Click on the button No, click Save Changes and Exit. Then open the Device Manager. Open the Sound and Video Game Controllers tab. Right-click on your sound device, select Uninstall. Restart your system, then go back to the Device Manager. Click on Action, then click on Check for Hardware Changes or Scan for Hardware Changes. The device driver should then be reinstalled. If you still cannot get the audio services to work properly, then the best course of action might be a system restore. Type in restore. Click on system restore. Click next. You'll want to find a system restore from before you started having these problems and then follow the on-screen prompts. For more helpful fixes, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Give this video a thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe to our channel. We are always adding new content aimed at making your digital universe a little bit easier. Thanks for watching and have a great day.